Are you tired of spending hours crafting blog posts from your YouTube videos, downloading that transcript, and dealing with those timestamps? However, in this video, I'll show you a game-changing automation workflow that transforms any YouTube URL into a fully published WordPress blog post in minutes. Scratch that, in seconds. Let's go. Hi there, I'm Larry, and on this channel, we simplify digital marketing. And in this case, the more you can automate, aka simplify, the more time you have to actually grow your business. So today, I'm walking you through an AutoKit automation workflow that converts any YouTube video URL into a fully formatted WordPress blog post without ever touching your keyboard. Let's jump in. All right, so let's get ready here. We're in the AutoKit dashboard, and I'm just gonna click on my folders here, then click on demo. And the one that we're gonna be using for this is this one right here. So let's take a look at how this is all working. So first initial thing we have, of course, in any workflow is a trigger. And in this case, we're using a Google Sheets as our trigger. Whenever a YouTube URL gets added to a row, now, because we're using Google Sheets as a trigger, there is a nuance in there that we have to set up a webhook, and I'll walk you through that. From our Google Sheets, it takes the URL that we've added in there, and it goes into Dumpling AI to generate a transcript from our YouTube URL. Then it goes and creates a summary text from the transcript, and then from the summary text, we then generate an image using Dall-E, and I will explain why we're using summary text to do that. And then from there, we're going to ask OpenAI, ChatGPT, to create a blog post for us using the transcript in HTML format. From there, we are going to ask OpenAI to create an SEO-optimized title for us. And then we're gonna put all the pieces that we've just generated into the create update post action. So that will create a draft post for us, but you could certainly go ahead and publish it live if you're feeling so bold. And optionally, the last two actions I have here is to look up the spreadsheet row to determine the row number, and then to update the row with additional components that I've got set up in the Google Sheet. Speaking of Google Sheets, let me just scroll right back up the top here and start with that. New or updated spreadsheet row is our only event. In the configuration tab, you'll see that we've got this webhook URL to Google Sheets trigger settings. So you'll need this, and we'll need to add an add-on to our Google Sheets. And there is a help article that you can go take a look at right here, and I'll leave a link to this in the description for you to go check it out. But let's head over to our Google Sheet and take a look. So how this trigger works is that if you add anything into column A, in this case, a YouTube URL, it will then kick off all of the actions. So how do we get this thing working? Well, we have to install an add-on, and the add-on is from AutoKit, formerly SureTriggers, and in this case, it's still called SureTriggers, but let's go into extensions, and then you want to go to add-ons, get add-ons, and then you want to do a search for, in this case, SureTriggers, and it's called the SureTriggers webhook. You'll then want to install it, give it all the permissions that it needs, and so then you have it available for you. Okay, now with our add-on in place, you then want to go into back into the extensions tab and then look for the SureTriggers webhook and then click on start setup. When you click on start setup, you want to enter in your webhook URL that you have here that you've been given from your automation over here. So you want to copy that and then go back over to your Google Sheet and paste it in. And then you want to set up the trigger column. So in this case, we are only concerned about column A. So whenever column A is updated, that will act as our trigger. All right, so that is our Google Sheets trigger, and I can click on continue. It's going to ask, hey, I need to have something come in so I can verify that it's working. You can go in here, go into your extensions, go into short triggers, under start setup, you'll see here it says send test. So if you exit out of this, put in a URL, click on send test, you'll get the notification here that this test was successful. You'll also see a message here that the test was successful, and then you can click submit, and then you can close the dialog box. So now let's get into our actions here. So in our Dumpling AI setup here, You'll need to have an API key with Dumpling AI. There are other scraper tools out there if you're more familiar with a different one. I'm just using Dumpling AI. With your AI API connection established, click on the Configure tab. And so here is where we're going to add in the video URL, which is dynamically coming in from our Google Sheet. So we want to add in the data from our Google Sheets, and that is the URL column A. So you just hit that at symbol and grab that in there. Our preferred language is English. We're going to click on test and click on test action. And we should see a transcript appear with the latest URL that we've just entered. And there you go. So now we can click on save. Then we get into the OpenAI ChatGPT setup. Here is the summary text that we want to generate. When you use OpenAI, you'll have to have an API key. So establish your API key, set it up here, and then you're good to go. So under the configuration tab, I'm using the 4.0 model, and I'm just grabbing the transcript and generating a summary. Now, why am I generating a summary? Is because Dall-E has a character limit. So if you have a very lengthy transcript from a very long video, you're going to max out your limit on your Dall-E and you'll never generate an image. So if we click on test here, you'll see that it's just giving you what's included in the transcript. And then we can click on save. So under the next step is to generate our image. And I do give it a little bit of a prompt here. It says using the following text. And in the following text, we want to add in the summary. So we'll just hit the at symbol here and go to our previous step, the summary text, and then select the summary from the content here. And so it's gonna say, use the following text, AKA the summary, to create a realistic image that directly references the context of the text. The output should be in JPEG format. That's not gonna happen, even though I try to specify that. And this should be maybe instead of 16:9, just do wide aspect ratio. And I say do not use words in or on the image, but it will do it anyway. So you get the idea. And then click on continue and then click on test action here and it will run and give us a URL that we can go check out. All right, our action tested successfully. So let's go quickly check out what this image looks like. And we'll just open up in a new browser window. So that is what it's going to look like. And as you can see, there's words everywhere misspelled. It's not using the new version of ChatGPT image. It's using the Dall-E. So you see the difference here. If I was using the ChatGPT image prompt, it would be probably a lot better. I haven't tried that yet. Okay, let's go back. We'll click save there. So that's our generate image. Then we want it to create a post and output it in HTML. So open this up. Again, using ChatGPT here, using the 4.0 model again, and I just give it a basic prompt. I want it to output the transcript provided into HTML syntax. And then I also specify some other aspects to this, and I wanted to embed the video. One of the defaults that WordPress does is if you put in the URL with that watch v equals that URL that we're putting into our Google Sheet here. If you put that URL in, WordPress understands that and will embed that video directly. So I just say, take that URL that we're putting into Google Sheets, put it out in a paragraph tag, and then that will be set up as an embed in WordPress. So down below here with the messaging, I'm asking it to reference the transcript and the actual URL of the video. Click on continue here. We'll click on test action. Okay, and so we've got a nice looking blog post. It's got our P with our watch V equals link in there. So that's going to come out as an embed, which is terrific. So we are done here. Let's click on save and we're almost done with our workflow. Our next stop is to create a title for our blog post. And the role I just gave it here, you're an SEO wizard. I could probably be a lot more creative here and you're tasked with creating an SEO optimized blog post title. And I ask it again to not use quotes or markup or markdown because it does tend to put that in there. And instead of 100 characters, I'm going to limit that to maybe 80 characters. And our max tokens is 200. We'll click continue, click on test action, scroll down, and now we've got a nice little title here. And click on save. Then we get into the WordPress post set up here in our next action. And so our app is WordPress. Our event is to create, update a post, You'll need a connection to your WordPress website. You can see here I have a couple. In order to establish a connection to your WordPress website, you'll need to install AutoKit on that website, and that's how you make the connection. So once you've got that, you can just select the connection you'd like to use, and then we'll click continue. And then the post URL will be blank because that will be auto-generated based on the title. The post type is posts. Our select post status is draft. If you're feeling brave, it's up to you. You can go published or you can schedule it out. I like to keep it in draft because AI is prone to make mistakes. Taxonomy is categories. And again, depending on what you've got installed on your WordPress website, you could have other options here. Taxonomy term. So if we've got categories, it's looking for a category, and I've just selected generically blog. It will ask for your author ID, so it can assign it to the person creating the post. And then we've put in our post title from the last step that we just did in OpenAI. And then we've asked it to use the generated image from ChatGPT Dall-E as our featured image. And then for the post content, I'm just putting in the HTML output that we've generated in OpenAI. And we've got to turn on that map item here that you see so that we can put our data in there. And I've got nothing for excerpt. And then we click on continue. And then we can click on test action. And it will generate a blog post for us that we can go check out. Switch over to posts, refresh here. And we'll click on preview. And we've now got a automatically generated blog post with some steps, some titles, H2 tags. Nice walkthrough. And again, here is our embedded video. So there you go. So that is our workflow. Now, the last couple of steps are, again, optional. So if we go back to my spreadsheet here, I have these other options here, post status, post title, and post URL. So what I've done in our workflow here is to have AutoKit look up the spreadsheet row that was just updated. So if we go into configuration here, we're looking up for the URL. If the URL matches the URL that came in from the first Google Sheet trigger, so if it matches this, okay, then click continue and click test action, and we'll see here that we have row 7. Save. So in order to update our row, we had to establish what that row number is, and the way to do that is with this lookup spreadsheet row step. Okay, so under update row, click on configure here, and you'll see that I'm now bringing in that data point that we established from the previous step. So you just hit the add symbol here, scroll down, and you'll now see row number established. Okay, so we want to select that as row number. So spreadsheet, worksheet, then we need the row number, and then we can update the content. In this case, this is static, so I'm saying the post has been generated, so I'm just posting that in there because that is our option between generate post and post generated. You can see here, those are our two options under post status. So I want to update that once we've established that we've got a draft post in WordPress. And then I put in the post title and the URL to the draft. So that's what that's coming in here. Here's the post title and here's the draft URL. And click on continue and click on save. So now that we have our workflow automation set up, the last step is to actually publish it. And so it's live and it's active. So whenever we enter in a URL in column A, it will use our webhook to trigger off our automation, and it will automatically generate a blog post for us in our WordPress website. If you're still copying and pasting your YouTube content by hand, it's time to upgrade. This AutoKit workflow gives you back your time while keeping your blog fresh and optimized. You'll find a link to get started with AutoKit in the description. And if you want to build this yourself, I'll also leave a link to this workflow in the description too. Hey, if this video has helped you, click that like button and subscribe for more digital marketing automations and tutorials just like this. I'll see you in the next video.